Okay, so 2-8 is all about applications of properties, or proportions, I said properties. Meaning we're using proportions to solve things. We're not just using proportions to practice. And in this case, we're looking at these two triangles. This language here, again, is telling us that they are similar. It says triangle RST is similar to triangle BCD. That means that R corresponds to B. The R is over here, and the B is over here. That's now telling us what these measurements correspond with. So I've got S corresponds to C. That means that this measurement, 8 feet, corresponds to the X. And that means the 5 feet corresponds to the 12 feet. And then we're just going to cross multiply and divide. X times 12, I'm sorry, 8 times 12 is equal to 5X. This is 96 is equal to 5X. Which means we're going to divide 96 by 5. And with the magic of the answer key in my book, I can tell you it is a decimal. 19.2 feet. Now, what I didn't show you is that the question asked, what is the length of, and then it just shows BC with a line over it, because B to C is where we find that X. And the line over it means the length of the triangle between B and C. So a lot of this is like math language around geometry, where you're kind of learning that language while we're doing the calculations of proportions, which you guys know how to do. Okay, if you have a book, I hope you do, open to page 128. There are two problems at the top of the page that we're going to do together. The first one, it walks us through it and gives us the answer. The second one we're going to do as an example. And again, these are on page 128. So if you look, it says FGHJKL, I'm sorry, there's no I for you people who are sad about I missing, corresponds to MNPQRS. Notice it's missing the O because it looks like a
zero,
right?
Zero.
So if F goes with M, use what you can see in your book on the very top of 128. And we're going to try to set up a proportion showing what goes with what. Find where the numbers are on the shape. You'll see right here, we have 4 centimeters is between the G and the H. What corresponds to G and H? Well, I look here, and G and H are the second and third letters. So it corresponds with the second and third letters, which are?
N
and P. What's between N and P?
6 centimeters.
So we're going to set this up as? They set it up as 6/4. It doesn't matter if you put the first shape, just as long as you're keeping track. Okay. I tend to put the first shape on top and the second shape on the bottom. So mine would have been set at 4/6, which is different than the way the book did it. And then KJ is 2 centimeters. What corresponds with KJ?
RQ.
RQ. And RQ is where the X is. So we're trying to find line, actually it would be QR if we read it in the right order, right? QRS. Does everybody still sing the song in your head trying to find the middle of the alphabet?
Yep.
What is the line QR equal to? Well, what's 2 times 6? 12 divided by 4? Is 3. And then we have to go back and look at the shape. What measurement are they using? Centimeters. Is this starting to feel okay? At first it looked like crazy stuff when I showed you all of those colors and all those coordinating lines, but is it starting to feel better?
It still looks like crazy stuff.
Okay, let's do number 1 underneath there. It says find the value of x in the diagram. If a, b, c, d is similar to w, x, y, and z. And now I know my ABCs. Kidding. X, y, z is in my head now. A, b coordinates with what?
W, x.
So we're going to put 5 over what?
7.
Is equal to 2 over x. How convenient that they put these in the right place. They're not twisted or turned or sideways or anything. 2 times 7? So we have 14 is equal to 5x. You probably will want calculators for this because now we're dividing by 5 and it's 2.8 inches. Okay? I think you guys are ready to do some practice on this.
Yeah. Maybe.
It's not going to be too many problems.
About 3 problems.
Nice try.
About 2 problems.
Page 130.
Okay.
We're going to do numbers 2 and 3. 6 through 8. And then 14 and 16. We're skipping 15.
Like I've been 16 correct with all.